Hello everyone, in the previous video we have discussed about the VLSI frontend, and today in this video we will discuss about VLSI backend. And for most such videos, do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon so that you will never miss the video, and follow us on Instagram. So let's talk about the VLSI design flow, the specification, architectural design, RTL design, RTL verification, synthesis, DFT. This we have already discussed in the front end. So if you haven't watched that video, you can watch that video. I put the link in the I button. So floor plan, placement, CTS, routing, sign off, clay fabrication, packaging and chip. So this all comes under the back end. So we will discuss these things in details. Okay, so let's talk about floor plan and placements. Basically in floor planning, we have to determine the shape and the size of the module. Like if you want to design a JK flip-flop, we have to check what should be the shape and what should be the size of that particular module. After that, there will be the placement. Where should we have to place this particular module? Let's take a general example. If you want to build a house in a land, so first we have to plan how house should be look like. After planning each and everything, what will be the size of the house, what will be the length of the house. After that, we have to put the material on it, like beams, columns and all. Like this, we have to do at the time of the designing IC. And this backend basically known as physical designing. Okay, so as you can see in your screen right now, like this, if this is the basically a microprocessor where we have placed the ALU, shifters, resistors, like this. Okay, this is the area, what should be the area of wire, what should be the distance between the shift register and the ALU. Like this, we have to plan and place. Okay, these things you have to do with the help of EDA tools. There are many EDA tools available in the market. We will talk about it later. Let's talk about the CTS, the clock tree synthesis. This is the very important step where we have to determine the speed of the particular chip. Like if you will check, your processor is 2.4 gigahertz to 5 gigahertz the speed, and the clock tree synthesis will determine the speed of your processor or the speed of your microcontroller. So this is the work of the CTS engineer. So here we will try to minimize the delay as much as we can. So let's talk about the routing. The routing is basically how we should connect the one, like we have to connect to one memory to the another memory. Like let's talk about the A registers, B register, C register. There are two types of routing, that is global routing and delay routing. So in global routing, if you will talk about the, there is A registers and B register. If you want to connect the A register, B registers, we can connect it randomly. There will be no measurement. So, but in detailed routing, we have to measure how we should connect A register with B registers. In detailed routing, we should be very specific about the details, how we should connect with A register with the B registers. Okay, as you can see in your screen, this is JK flip-flop, and here we have placed and they routed everything. Like this is the, if you will talk about, this is the MOS. Previously we used to build the processor and everything through the CMOS technology, but now we are using the FinFET technology to build the processors. Like this, you can see this is the MOS and these are connected. We don't use the programming language here. Basically we put everything with the help of the tools and the commands. Okay, everything will be in the tools. So now the steps comes in the sign off. Now before fabrication, we have to do testing. So in the sign off, we have to check whether everything is correct or not. Like in the front end, we do the verification part. So in the back end, in the sign off part, we will do verify whether the connections are proper or not. So to verify, now the IC is ready for the fabrication. At the fab lab, we will give the IC design. Now the fab lab will make the IC, and at last we will get the chips. Now at last, after fabricating the IC, it is not suitable for the market. Before this IC comes to the market, before that we have to check it whether this IC is working as per the instruction or not. So this is the ATP machine, which we generally use by the DFT engineer to check the whether the IC is working correctly or not. Okay, and in your right side you can see this is the fab lab. Last we will get this processor or this ICs in the market. You can see in your laptop or in your phones what are the requirements. So these all things we have discussed, what is the VLSI backend. Now how you can be a backend engineer. First of all, you have to focus on digital electronics and analog electronics. Most important is AIC, analog integrated circuit. After that, go for CMOS, complete understanding of CMOS, everything related to the channel length, depth, width, everything. Okay, and after that you have to go for the EDA tools. Tools are available in the market, and in the EDA tools you have to design like a shift register, flip-flops. After that you should go for the projects, and the projects are available in the IEEE websites. From there you can easily download the paper and read the paper, and after that follow the instruction. The software which we use for the EDA tools are Synopsys EDA tools, Cadence, Mentor Graphics, and Xilinx. These are the top companies, and almost every industry use these companies' tools. Okay, now the companies which hires the backend engineers or the physical design engineers are Synopsys, Cadence, Mentor Graphics, Xilinx, and there are many other companies which hires the VLSI backend engineers. Okay, and the average salary will be 5 lakhs to 10 lakh per annum for the freshers. So I hope this video you find informative and you got to know something new today, and you have learned so much about the VLSI backend. For more such videos, do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon. So that's it for now. So I will be back with another video in the next week. So take care. Bye bye.